more difficult than for others. And even when independence finally came, the future was uncertain, with economic and political upheaval never far away. In this regard, I congratulate the CCSA for opening an office every Friday to provide support and advice and create new opportunities for members of the Congolese community. I am sure that planning for next year's celebrations to mark the 60th anniversary of independence will start soon. Once again, I thank you for the opportunity to speak at this important event and wish everyone an enjoyable evening.
Your country, your homeland, needs the diaspora, the Congolese diaspora, to prosper and to actually democratize itself. And Australia needs and welcomes the Congolese community, as well as other African communities, to grow its diversity and to grow its prosperity. You are a very, very welcome group in Australia, and I can see that your young people are going to make a difference here. I look forward to working with you, as I have been working with your committee in the past.
Well, it's a pleasure to be here, but also I have to say that I was extremely nervous being invited to come and speak tonight, because I know that I simply cannot compete with all the beautiful dresses that the women will be wearing. I would like to celebrate with you your 59th year of independence from colonialism. So the Australian Refugee Association will do whatever we can to support you in that journey, and as a strong community association, we'll support you to welcome new Congolese migrants to South Australia, and we will support you as a community association. We're very proud to be associated with you, and have a wonderful celebration tonight, and we best wishes for the years ahead. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, leaders, girls and boys, today we come together to celebrate. We celebrate 59 years of the independence of the Congo. And I'm delighted to see so many leaders. We have Virginie for AMRC, Laura from Samiak, Mabok. Wonderful to have you here again. And I see our friends from the Sierra Leone community is here. So my message tonight on this day of celebration is to work together, to support each other, knowing that you have a shared background, but more importantly, a shared future here in Australia.
Now, a simple message for me to you all.
Un message très simple pour vous tous.
Whether you are from Bok Congolese background or anyone who comes tonight,
que vous soyez d'origine congolaise ou pas, mais
my simple message is this.
Mon message est ceci.
Unity builds a nation.
L'unité construit une nation.
A nation which is not built in unity,
une nation qui n'est pas construite sur l'unité,
divide itself,
se divise tout seul,
fight against itself,
se bat entre eux,
and kill itself,
et se tue entre eux.
A lot of blood was shed for us to have the Independence Day that we have today and gain the freedom. Now, the final point I really want to touch on, and this will allow you to then see where we want to carry the community and where we want to take the youth themselves, is the fact that I want you guys to remember this quote. It's the fact that pressure creates diamonds and fire refines gold. So in the sense that you can't have diamonds in the ground without the pressure of the ground to form them to start with, and you can't have gold to be 100% purified if you don't have the fire to burn away the impurities, burn away the problems that have already been there, to then present the gold itself.
That's why you can see me now with the map of Africa.
Ce n'est pas du tout une carte d'Afrique, mais c'est une guitare fabriquée en forme d'Afrique.
It's not just a map of Africa, it's a guitar in the form of Africa.
C'est parce que mon sang est vraiment africain.
Because I feel Africa in my blood.
Patience et kanga.
Et c'était comme ça la reconnaissance de tous les volontaires qui ont beaucoup aidé ce soir. Et nous voulons continuer, merci.
Everin, and I'm so proud to be here today. It was such a good event. We had quite a few people to turn up as well. And yeah, I can't wait for next year and see how we go, and I hope that it goes better next year. Yeah.
We try to change the perception of how Africans understand police. Police shouldn't just be that they come around when there is trouble, and they come around when trouble is about to happen. We want to change that understanding that when you have an event, we come, we sit with you, we fellowship with you, we interact with you to bridge that gap of between the South Australian police and the African community. Police are friendly people, and this is what we are here to preach. So happy Independence Day to Congolese community in South Australia and the world at large. And viva pour la République de Congo et joyeux l'indépendance.
Revealing that the event was about the Congolese 59th Independence Day.
I'm just so thankful that our community on our 59th Independence anniversary, we had a great time. It was a moment that it will stay in our history in Australia. We share with our brothers, as the theme for our congregation is unity. Unity for everyone. Unity is everyone has to be involved. It's not one person. Unity is not for the president. It's not for the vice president. It's not for the secretary. It's for each one of us. Play your role as a Congolese. Make yourself known. Make yourself seen. So people can know you are part of the community. We need your support. Nobody can do it. No one can do it on his own. Not the president, not the vice president, not the secretary, not the treasurer, but each one of us as Congolese. Make yourself known. Put your hands on the vehicle. Let's move together. Let's make this happen. Let our young people coming after us realize that we left some traces where they can walk, our footsteps, where we work, and show them that this is our community. And then we can go home and build our country the same as our ancestors wanted it to be. I thank you, all of you. Next time, show yourself, be part of it. Come and enjoy with us. Thank you. Happy 50th anniversary, Congolese Independence.
Today was really amazing. Today was the 59th Independence Day for Congolese people, and I really enjoyed the performing and the choir that would sing, the PACC, that's from our church, that's our choir as well. They did pretty good, amazing job
today,
as well.
In our Independence Day for Congolese community in South Australia, we are so happy. People come different area. We say thank you very much. And it's not the first, the second. We need to support our communities. We just want this thing to be finished today or tomorrow. And the secondly, we need as a community to come and support us, like they support us today. And the Congolese too, they can support as a community. I'm talking here, my name is Amisi. The people doesn't know me. I'm Congolese from Congo, and their God Association is calling ADFM in Luvira. I'm helping people, other Congolese, my brothers and sisters, which one left over. Every year I'm sending containers from Adelaide to Congo, helping people, poor people, and the people doesn't have. For all Congolese, which one can receive this message, please try to do something home. People suffer, orphanage, people dead by anger, people dead with no clothes. Other thing which one you can help is no education. We are educated person. We need to get this education to other people out. Thank you very much for what you can see me on behalf of Congolese. My name is Amis ADFM Uvira. I'm everywhere, and I want to do something better for good. Thank you very much.